16. If they could have blamed you, then they must also blame me. Because when this idea came, I was the first person you spoke to about it. And I was the first person to say that as a young filmmaker, you must have your time to be expressed any way you like. We spoke together before you wrote the first draft of this film. And you gave me the first draft of the film to read before the subsequent films. I have been working with Jamil for the last 7 years. We made a small time called Descent together, and this is the second film of his that we've produced for him as Moments Entertainment. So, as a filmmaker who has been working in the industry since 1974, before the film came, what you were supposed to see today, Jamil and I saw it 3 days ago, and the two of us looked at each other, and I said to Jamil, I'm proud of you. Okay, I said to him, you are very brave, and that's what we need in young African filmmakers. Okay, and he calls me daddy because we've been working together for 5 years, and of good report was the story he told me first of all, and I said, let's go for it. So, X-Team, it's okay, we're going to be in this battle together. Thank you.
I think that we're all going to be together. The only shock for me that in 1980 I was detained during the dark old days of apartheid. I can't believe in 2013, when we talk about a new South Africa on the eve of Nelson Mandela's birthday, that we are being censored. Yeah. Jamil, we love you.
Really sad day. I mean, I didn't know about this until a few minutes ago. And having run the festival in Cape Town for a long time and loved cinema, and having gone to the Labia for a long time during apartheid, during censorship, I'm completely astounded. I think it's unconstitutional. There are many films that are made about the subject matter. To me, it didn't even register, even though I'm a lawyer. I think it's completely over the top. We have received before very moralizing letters from state agencies regarding the film. And I just don't believe that it's the function of the state to censor us in this manner. And it's a way in which the national Christian ideology of the past is now being revisited through some other ideology. And I just think it's very sad, and I think it's very sad for South Africa.
Wow.
I was really sad every night that we were able to show this remarkable film. We want to quickly engage in a Q&A. If any members of the audience have any questions, do we have a roving mic? Can we get a roving mic to? And given the circumstances, we will also, those people who didn't receive an invite to the actual party, who paid for their tickets, please come join our party. We'll be a little bit tight, but please come. Okay. Sarah, please ask your question.
I'd like to just, Peter knows me as a member of the committee that programs for DIFF, and I've seen the film that I don't want to speak about it, but I just want to say that I can't really believe that this film, that not any film, this film would be censored, because it depicts a woman being victimized. And to censor it is evidence of bureaucrats who are not able to detach themselves from the male gaze in any possible way. They can only see a sexualized, or a woman who's, a young woman, who's being depicted as a victim of sexual violence, as an object of sexuality, as object of sexual attraction. There's nothing in the framework that is making any allowance for the fact that this is a victim, not an object of sexual desire. If it were able to take victimhood of femininity into account, it wouldn't censor this film.
Wow.
You are appealing for our support in some form or format, besides the committee members and all the structures that were here that made such events possible. Us as normal citizens, how do we engage with you to ensure that future knowledge like this, because I see it as knowledge, as awareness, is not centered?
My response is that that's a question that we all have to answer and take responsibility for, collectively as a society and as individual human beings. No, I don't think that we can just blame the Film Publication Board. I think we need to blame the society we live in, which allows those things to happen. You know, we also, though, have the capacity to help change these things. Yes, a petition is, it's incredibly easy to start a global petition nowadays. I mean, I think this is something that would be part of an advice.org petition. I must stress, however, that we have appealed the decision. We appealed the decision this afternoon when we got the paperwork to do so. They didn't make an emergency watching to, viewing to try and see if they could if we could show it tonight. It is possible that they will change their mind and that later screenings of the film will next week might occur. So let's hope.
In terms of fighting this, I would encourage any of the invited, present, not present, government representatives with their added political power to put their names behind this and stand up for something that is right. Because we the people can only do so much. Your name has more signing power, so you guys step up to the plate.
I would really like someone, Jamil, if not you, from the cast or the crew, to come and speak. We need to hear from you guys how you feel about it. Isn't that important? Just something. Petronella, producers, I think it's very important just to voice out how you're feeling about this whole decision. Petronella, come. I can see. Come. Come, love. We need to hear from you.
I really think it's important that we don't continue to keep our voices silent. And therefore, cast, if you have something to say, please say it. They've tried to censor us, and it's up to us to really take the stage.
When you're telling truth. It seems like it's hard for people to actually understand that. And for me, this was a cry out of what's actually happening to my young sisters, our young girls in the townships, that we actually run into older men for safety and for a better life. Yes, there was nudity, but I would never do anything that wasn't done properly. I trusted Jamil in the story. There was nothing too explicit. On behalf of the team, we stand by this film. We stand by Jamil. We stand by Ulwazi, and we will fight. Thank you.
Hi, everybody. My name is Toby Mkwanazi. I was very fortunate to have been cast in the film of Good Report by Jamil. I've been in the entertainment industry since I was a child. I will tell you how old I am, but practically since 1995. And I'm very fortunate to have known Jamil for about 15 years now. The way Jamil is so passionate about storytelling, the way he is so intelligent, the way he conceptualizes a subject, the way he researches a subject, I can't believe how a film of this nature that was so intelligent and so well thought out by a filmmaker, not a chancer, not somebody who just was picked up from the street, by a filmmaker could be just discarded of in this way. I actually thought it was a joke when I heard it. I thought it was some sort of a gimmick, you know, to get us excited about the film, you know. I saw the audience as well when they read the disclaimer right there. They laughed. I was one of them. And then when somebody got up here to tell us, you know, the news, we still thought it was some sort of a gimmick. I'm very shocked. And I'm really hoping that everybody here in the audience can get an opportunity to see the film. I won't go too much into details. But one thing I can say to Jamil, because I know everybody is shattered, everybody who's part of this team, whether they're here or not here, even the crew members, I know that they would be very, very disappointed. But let us remember that the greatest artists of our times and the people in our past were very controversial. And that controversy right now is something that we regard as groundbreaking. Am I right or am I wrong? All the artists that we, who have depicted a lifestyle of their time were seen as controversial or bad, you know, but those were people who were groundbreakers. So the one thing I could say to Jamil right now is this is a very epic moment in his life, in his career, and he shouldn't see it as a disappointment. He should see himself as a legend in the making. And that's one thing I have to say. Thank you very much.
Hello? My name is Phoenix Nagel. I play Yang Giswa, who's Nolita's best friend. My character is basically the girl that influences the younger girls into doing the wrong thing. I didn't realize the magnitude of this lesson until this moment right now. It seems that when there's something that's very important that people are supposed to know and recognize, that's the minute that the fear comes in and it's stopped in its tracks. I think that the lesson in itself is in us all being here gathering to see a good report. And even if we didn't see the movie for what it, like what we as the cast and crew created, the actual message comes across, because it's important for everybody to recognize a lesson within themselves, not only because of a movie that we saw. I think that because they censored the movie, that should give more importance to the issues that we have going on in the country in terms of young girls actually being manipulated to do the wrong thing because of money and because of the circumstances that are in their communities. Perhaps this in itself is a chance for us to go and look into other forms of information rather than what we're given, rather than the information that is given to us. If we don't get to see this movie today, perhaps we can find it in another way. perhaps we can learn the lesson that this movie stands for, rather than just being here and saying that we were here to see the movie. So in that way, congratulations, Jamil, for creating something that you actually expressed. And even if we don't get to see the movie today, I'm sure the lesson in terms of censorship, I hope that everybody recognizes that there is a lesson in tonight. There's something that's happening around us that we need to recognize. And if we don't stop it now, it's actually going to grow bigger. And that's what the lesson of this evening is.
Good evening, everybody. Very loud. My name is Leanne Van Rooy. I'm an actor. I'm also a teacher, I'm a mother, I'm a wife, I'm a sister, I have a mother, I have friends. I've been in the industry since 1994. I do work that really, really interests me. I do work that I know is going to be effective, and I do and tell stories that I know will live in the hearts and in the eyes of everybody who sees or who hears stories. My medium is not only film, it's also stage, it's voice work. We do what we can to survive. It's a very, very tough industry, as you all know. So, when one is presented with a script, of course you're going to make a decision and say, for me, the question that I pose to myself is, will I live with myself if my daughter one day watches it? Will she be proud of me and my work, which is up on a screen? Everything that I do is about the future. Even stupid things, which is not so stupid, like recycling, make a better future for the future. To get back to the point, I play Constable Arendse. She is a police woman, daily grind, and she is looking after or looking for a girl that goes missing. So I'm in about one third of the movie. What's interesting to me about the movie is not only that as a woman, I get to showcase a really strong, formidable force and power as a woman, where the fact that she's a woman doesn't get in her way of doing her job. But she also makes a decision which takes her away from her job without giving the story away. And sometimes I wonder, because I have many friends that are policemen and women, and I hear the stories that they tell, and we look at justice in this country, the violence and the waves of violence that just keep hitting us in the face. And there's just one time when the character is faced with the possibility of doing something about it. And she does. It's not the law, but she does it. Because she knows if she does that thing, then at least on her level, humanity in her mind will be saved from one skurki, one bad person off the street. Jamil, I'm very sorry. I'm very sad. I know how hard you worked and everybody else worked on this particular production. And I hope that there is something that can be done about it, because I think it is a story which needs to be told. It's a story which shows South Africa in quite a brutal and quite an honest way, in a very truthful way, and I know that every single person that worked on this production tried to really look deep within themselves to give the truth so that the audience will be able to see and feel, and maybe with that in mind, change.
I think we need to close, and basically what we want to say to Jamil and to all of you who don't know Jamil is that he is truly a new voice in South Africa. If you've seen any of his films, and if he tells you in the last 10 years, he's been here so many times with so many different pieces of art and work. He has had a very tough time bringing the film here today. And this film's going to show in Toronto, it's going to show in Rotterdam, it's going to show in Dubai, and it's not showing at home. I think that is sad. That is really, really sad. And I hope that the powers that be who are in this space, the National Film and Video Foundation, the Department of Arts and Culture, the artist activists that you are and that we are, that we do something about this. Thank you and good night.
Yeah, I should have said that as producers of the film, we will immediately challenge this in the Constitutional Court. And if all of you can tweet, Facebook, and you can put up as much as you can
at DIFF. The Twitter name and the Twitter handle is at DIFF.
Okay, Peter, do you come? Ladies and gentlemen, unfortunately, it's heartbreaking, but this is the opening night of the 34th edition of the Durban International Film Festival.